Country music legend and North Carolina native Ronnie Milsap has been entertaining fans for more than 50 years. And one constant during his career has been his wife, Joycey.
Yeah, sadly, Ronnie announced to his fans last month that she has passed away. The couple would have been married 56 years this Saturday. Well, Ronnie recently sat down with our Brian Stevenson to talk about his loss and his amazing career.
Ronnie Milsap's music has influenced people around the world, but we were surprised to hear about some of his earliest music memories.
Channel 3 in Charlotte reached all the way to Graham County. That's where I grew up in western North Carolina. We could pick up Channel 3.
We caught up with the singer ahead of a recent show in Greensboro. He told us all about the music he heard on WBTV and on the radio. Milsap grew up poor in his hometown of Robbinsville, deep in the North Carolina mountains between Murphy and Cherokee. His home life wasn't great. His mom thought his blindness was punishment for sin. But his family wanted him to be successful, so he was sent to the North Carolina School for the Blind. He says his teachers helped him discover his love of song.
So I started playing violin at 7 and piano at 8 with individual teachers that would tell you what you were doing right and what you were doing wrong and help to refine what you're doing. So the music side is something I fell in love with pretty early.
Early in his career, Milsap landed the gig of a lifetime, playing studio piano for none other than Elvis Presley on his song, Kentucky Rain.
And when I saw Elvis, say, I love what you played on Kentucky Rain. More thunder on the piano, Milsap. It was great. I was an Elvis fan.
He also played with the great Ray Charles. When Ray heard Ronnie play, he gave him good advice.
You just gotta go out and be accessible. You gotta be busy, you gotta be out and let people know what gift that God has given you. And it is a gift.
Then in Nashville, he met producer Jack Johnson.
He wasn't sure if he could make it happen for a blind artist. And I was the first one to come to Nashville, a blind artist, to try it. And he got me a deal with RCA. All of a sudden, we got records coming out, playing all over North Carolina. And they said, is that Ronald Milsap? Is that him? Yeah, it sure is. He went to Nashville and he made it.
I wouldn't have missed it for the world.
Over the years, Ronnie has produced more than 30 albums and 40 number one hits. Fans love him.
Well, they mean everything to me, of course. I wouldn't be in this nice bus without the fans. I wouldn't be living in Nashville without the fans. They've sustained me all the way.
That love between artists and fans, that's something his longtime guitar player and tour manager has seen firsthand.
Most people you'll go see, they'll sing one or two styles over the course of the entire evening, and Ronnie will flawlessly do pop, country, R&B, jazz, blues, you know, you name it, and just like it's effortless.
But it's his longtime number one fan that he misses so much.
It was all to do with my wife, Joycey. She was my biggest fan, and she told me what I was doing right. I was really singing them all to her, and the loss of her is just more than I can bear, I think. But I mean, you gotta keep going on.
And you're the only love in my life.
Easy to see such a special bond between Ronnie and his beloved Joycey. But at 78, he is not slowing down. He has a new album out called A Better Word for Love.